Hello YouTube, my name's Nero and today we're going to have another Call of Duty Black Ops 3 wishlist video. So what I'm going to do with this video is kind of expand upon my last wishlist video while going really, really in depth with a lot of my comments and a lot of my kind of wishes and general hopes that I have for the game. Of course, we've already learned a lot about Call of Duty Black Ops 3. We already know a lot that's going to be happening with the game and a lot that's going to be featured within the game, but there's still a lot of stuff that we don't know a lot about, and I just want to give more general opinions and just things I would like to see within the game, going over the weapons, the perks, the kill streaks, the prestige system, the maps, the game modes, the zombies, all that stuff, right? I've got a lot of stuff. I told you guys in my last video that if you would like to see a longer, more detailed, more in-depth wishlist video, to let me know. And a lot of you responded to that. A lot of you wanted to see a longer video just talking about Black Ops 3 in general, so that's what we're going to be doing here in this video. So hopefully you guys all sit back, relax, get comfy, because it could be a very long video. Just to try and make sure that I actually had everything written down for this, I was actually sitting here with a notepad open and just writing down everything as that came to me, right? I'm hoping that I remember everything, but I guarantee by the time I'm finished with this video, by the time it's like rendering out, I'm like, I forgot to mention the one thing, and whatever that one thing may be, I don't know what it's going to be, but I guarantee I'm going to forget stuff in here. But if you guys have any questions or more comments, because I read through all your comments in the last video, I actually went through and refreshed them and like went through and looked through them again today, just to get your guys' opinions and your guys' feedback and kind of give myself a refresher on that as well. So there's definitely a lot of stuff you guys want to see in the game, and I think you guys will agree with a lot of stuff I have to say in this video. So let's hop into it. First and foremost, the number one thing that everybody has said about Black Ops 3, they don't want exosuits to be in the game. Of course, I don't want them to be there either, and we already know that they're not going to be in the game, at least in the current state that Advanced Warfare is in, right? It's not going to be just like Advanced Warfare. It's going to be a thruster pack system, which is going to be kind of similar to an exosuit in that you can kind of double jump in a way, but it's a lot slower, a lot clunkier. It's not going to be nearly as smooth, and it's not going to be as fast paced as what we have in Call of Duty Advanced Warfare. So hopefully that's going to be good. For the videos that we've seen from the people out there that have actually been able to play a very early build of the game, they say that it's not like Advanced Warfare. It's not like having an exosuit. So I'll just put my faith in them. I'll put my faith in prayer. I can just say, hopefully it's not going to be too much like it. Hopefully it's going to be just like a slightly enhanced version of Black Ops 2 in terms of the movement system, right? So hopefully that'll be the case. Skill-based matchmaking. A lot of people talk about skill-based matchmaking. It's already confirmed, you guys will know, to be just like Black Ops 2. There's no up in it. There's no revamp to it. There's no increasing it or anything like that. It's going to be just like it was in Black Ops 2. And in my opinion, Black Ops 2, I didn't know there was skill-based matchmaking. I basically would play a game, right? And it would either be really competitive or it wouldn't be competitive at all. There's really no in between to that. Some matches we would go up against these people that were so ridiculously good, and the match would be just, we were fighting tooth and nail, some of the most competitive matches I've ever had in public matches before. Of course, I've done game battles and stuff like that, but some of those competitive public matches I've ever seen was in Black Ops 2, and that was fun. But then there was other times where the opposing team was just awful, and we were just calling in VSATs nonstop and just raining down kill streaks and just having a whole lot of fun as well. So if it's going to be like that, I'm okay with that. It's either going to be really fun, really competitive matches occasionally, but for the most part, it's going to be more generally laid back as compared to Advanced Warfare, so I'm definitely looking forward to that. So let's start going into this. Let's start getting further in here and going in-depth as to every possible little nook and cranny detail about how Call of Duty is played, and let's just start talking about it. So first and foremost, let's go with the leveling speed and the leveling system. So I want it to be similar to Advanced Warfare, to be perfectly honest. Similar to Advanced Warfare or similar to Black Ops 2. If you notice in those games, you level really quickly. Leveling up is pretty simple in these games. You know, you can get up to a high rank very quickly. I think it took me in Black Ops 2 like, oh, there's some double XP weekends involved, I believe. I think it took me maybe 5 days of playtime to get to Prestige Master. Maybe, you know, just on the lower end of 6 days of playtime, somewhere in that range. We can go back. I have a video of it somewhere, but we can go back and look at the exact numbers. But it didn't take me very long. I got there before Christmas, you know. I played that game a ton, just so much. I got burned out on it really quick, though, just because I played so much. But yeah, it didn't take very long. In terms of just general playtime, it didn't take that long to get up there. Whereas in Modern Warfare 2, the leveling was a lot worse. It took a lot longer to level up. Even if you were playing only Surge and Destroyer, trying to level up the best you could, it would still take players anywhere between, you know, 12 and 20 days of playtime to get up a 10th prestige legitimately in that game. It took a very, very long time, and I'm not a big fan of that, to be honest. I'd rather have the fast, the quick progression. I'd like to have 15 prestiges. That would be great. In terms of a prestige system, I'd like to have 15 prestiges plus a prestige master. I think that's about good. That's a lot of leveling up there. I don't think I like the idea of having 30 prestiges like Advanced Warfare, but, you know, they have so much double XP and so many events and stuff that really doesn't matter. Like, players that don't even play a ton can still get up to those super high ranks if they would like to, but I think 15 prestiges plus a Master Prestige would probably be about right, but I like the fast leveling compared to, you know, the other Call of Duty games where you don't level that fast. I'd rather have the Advanced Warfare and Black Ops 2 style leveling where you go relatively quickly. There's a nice progression system there which kind of motivates you to continue playing and still giving you a permanent unlock at the start of each prestige, which is pretty nice. If you have a specific weapon that's like your favorite weapon, you know, you can just have it right away, and that's great. If when you prestige, you use your one unlock token to be able to bring that gun with you, and then you have to unlock the rest of the things by actually leveling up, and you level up pretty quickly. I just like that system a lot. Let's talk about weapons, all right? So weapons are, of course, one of the biggest things, if not the biggest thing, about Call of Duty. So for Black Ops 3, I'd like to see more variety than ever. I'd like to see a ton of weapons, tons of weapons to choose from, right? I want like 10 assault rifles in this game, 10 submachine guns, 7 light machine guns or heavy weapons, wherever you want to call them. I'd like to have 5 sniper rifles each. I'd like to have 5 shotguns in there as well. Throw in some special weapons. Throw in 5 special weapons if you could. Things like crossbows, things like ballistic knives, things like that, you know. That all would just be great. I'd like to have a lot of variety in there. Rather than like Advanced Warfare where we have 3 shotguns. We have like 1 pump action. We have a semi-automatic shotgun and we have a full auto shotgun. That's not a ton of variety. Whereas if we had 5 shotguns in Black Ops 3, they could give us like a pump action shotgun, a pump action shotgun with a slug, a semi-automatic shotgun, a full auto shotgun, and a double barrel. I would love a double barrel, man. A good double barrel shotgun like the World at War double barrel. That's what I would like to see. You know, the Rangers from Modern Warfare 2 were okay, but they didn't really the Rangers didn't have very much range, as punny as that is. But you know, a good double barrel shotgun I think could be a whole lot of fun. I think it'd also be very cool if they could somehow implement historical weapons into the multiplayer. That'd be definitely a bonus for me, because this game technically is still set in the same story, the same timeline, I guess, as the World at War and the Black Ops campaigns, which of course were set in Vietnam as well as World War 2. So it's possible that some of these guns would show up in there in terms of the recoil pattern of the weapons. I'd love to have a ton of recoil on these guns, similar to Black Ops 1, although I don't think it's going to be very likely because we're going to be in the future, and of course the more futuristic the weapons are, plus you look at the fact that we're going to be like these half cyborg specialist people where some of them are going to be like have full robotic arms and stuff like that. So I can't picture gun kick really being a mechanic too much in this game, but we'll have to see about that. But yeah, those are my general thoughts on weapons in Black Ops 3. I'd like to see a ton of variety, you know, 10 assault rifles, have a bunch of them in there, have a couple full auto ones, have a couple burst ones, a couple semi-automatic ones, just have a bunch of variety in there. In terms of submachine guns, have a lot of variety in there, have like your, you know, your long range SMGs like your MTAR-Xs, but also still have your cool UMP-45 style ones, which are just heavy hitters, then have your low damage but high fire rate like MP-11 or Uzi style. Just have a bunch of variety in there in terms of the weapons. Just have a bunch of weapons thrown in there as well. I would like that a whole lot. In terms of perks, all right, let's talk about the perks here. I'd like it to be similar to Black Ops 2, I suppose. When I look back at Black Ops 2 perks, I enjoyed them for the most part. Advanced Warfare perks, don't get me wrong, are not that bad, but I feel like they chose the slots wrong in Advanced Warfare. I don't feel so they did that great. Most of the good perks, in my opinion, in Advanced Warfare are in the perk 3 slot. You look at the fact that Scavenger's down there, as well as Blast Suppressor, and you've got Toughness in there, and you've got Hardline in there, and you've got Hardwired in there. All of those are like really, 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 really clutch perks and really good perks that I would just love to have all the time. But you have to pick only 2 of them at the most, which is usually Toughness and Blast Suppressor. And if you want Toughness and Blast Suppressor, you can't have Hardline. You can't have Scavenger as well. I just feel so that they weren't like layered very well. Whereas compared to Black Ops 2, it seemed pretty balanced. I like the Black Ops 2 perks overall. Now, if they wanted to toss in some extra ones, like Advanced Warfare, for example, brought into the fold, like Advanced Warfare, of course, they brought in peripherals and they brought in Gung Ho. If they wanted to add in perks like that, I'm perfectly fine with that. But for the most part, just bring in more Black Ops 2 style perks. Would I like to see pro perks? I wouldn't be against the idea of pro perks, to be honest. I never thought pro perks was a bad thing. I actually kind of liked it. I like the extra challenge of, oh boy, I got Stopping Power Pro, or I got Slave Hand Pro now. Now I get this extra bonus. Stopping Power, man, whatever happened to that? But I guarantee, let's not even talk about Stopping Power. It's not going to come back. Although I like Stopping Power, it's not going to come back because it really doesn't make sense to bring it back. But I wouldn't be against it. I wouldn't be against pro perks. I don't think there's going to be. And if I had to pick, I'd say, nah, just don't bring back pro perks, I guess. Just leave it kind of like it was in Black Ops 2. It will be good. I think that'd be probably for the best for everybody. Kill streaks. Let's talk about the kill streaks, ladies and gentlemen. So I think some of you guys are longtime fans of the channel. You probably already know what I would like to see for kill streaks, but let's go over it regardless. Kill streaks in Black Ops 3. Make them wild, man. Just make them go crazy. What I think makes Call of Duty fun, as compared to other FPS games out there, there's a ton of them on the market, right? Well, I think one of the reasons Call of Duty is so successful and why a lot of people like Call of Duty is the kill streaks, right? There's nothing like going wild with a crazy strong kill streak, right? A good kill streak system also works as a great reward system, right? That encourages players to continue the working and continue wanting to play to try to get better to earn these powerful kill streaks. I want to see chopper gunners. I want to see boar ships and dogs and swarms and VSATs, napalms. I want to see hellfires, emergency airdrops, harrier strikes. Just throw in all kinds of crazy fun kill streaks, man. Make them difficult to get, but make it once you do earn them, they are powerful, right? One of the big problems we had in Modern Warfare 3, this is my own opinion, some of you guys may disagree, but in my opinion, Modern Warfare 3 and Ghost, the last two Infinity Ward games, they had some good kill streaks in the game, but they were really hard to earn, and they didn't do a lot for you when when you actually got them, right? Like, I think back to Modern Warfare 3, the AC-130, which in Modern Warfare 2, the AC-130 was so good, man. It doesn't matter if they were trying to use things like Blind Eye or anything like that. It did not matter. You would just rain down death and destruction if you were using an AC-130 in Modern Warfare 2, but they end up changing that in Modern Warfare 3 by giving them spawn protection, making it so if they just respawn, they're basically invincible from killstreaks for like the first 5 seconds. And they also did the same thing in Call of Duty Ghost, and just that little thing that they did there made it so a lot of the killstreaks just aren't very good. You know, the best killstreaks were the ones that you put up that are AI controlled, and you don't even really get to have fun with it. Whereas in Call of Duty years past, you know, you get up there in an AC-130, you get up there in a chopper gunner, you throw out your harrier strike, you call in your emergency airdrop, and just you have tons of killstreaks going on. I think that's the most fun system to have. I'd like that to be like it was back in the day, you know, where killstreaks just kind of reign supreme. Of course, you're like, oh, but Nero, then Call of Duty is gonna be all about killstreaks. Yeah, because that's what makes Call of Duty different than other first-person shooter games. If you want a gun-on-gun game, there's Counter-Strike, there's Titanfall, you know, well, I guess Titanfall's got Titans in there. There's Battlefield, like, there's a bunch of games that are gun-on-gun. I don't think there's any lack of gun-on-gun stuff. I'd like to see a lot of killstreak. Of course, Call of Duty's still going to primarily be gun-on-gun, but you also throw in more killstreaks, I think that's going to be a lot of fun for everybody, man. Having killstreaks and just the joy you get of earning that specific killstreak and calling it in and having it go to work is so great. But then there's other times where you work your way up once again, for example, to an AC-130, that gets you 2 kills. And you're like, oh, well, I'm so glad I worked so hard for that AC-130 that is just completely neutered up there in the air that can't do anything. One, I can't see anybody. You know, I've been running, and just to kind of go off topic a little bit, I've been running a bit more of the Vulcan and a bit more of the Missile Strike just to try them out. And you notice from like the gameplay and stuff, it just, there's nobody. Even in Ground War, there's 9 people on the other team, just everybody's using Blind Eye all the time. And these killstreaks are like next to worthless, you know, because I cannot see anybody and it's so ridiculously annoying. You know, I would just like for killstreaks to kind of reign supreme a little bit again, rather than the entire game just being gun on gun. But, you know, that may just be me. I don't like it when there's easy counters to a lot of things. I like it more like the Modern Warfare 2 and these Black Ops and the Black Ops 2 systems, where it wasn't as easy to counter a lot of the killstreaks. And also, to end off the killstreaks, of course, I would love to see a MOAB. I would love to see a chem strike style streak in the game as well. Just I think that's what I would like to see. I think most people would agree with that. Some people say, oh no, don't add those into the game, but it's like, why? I mean, it's not going to affect you. If you let someone on the other team give up a 25 kill streak or 30 kill streak, whatever it would be, then you kind of deserve to have a kill streak come in and kill everybody. You know, I've never been DNA bombed. I've never seen a single DNA bomb in one of my lobbies. No one on my team's ever gotten a DNA bomb. Nobody on the opposing team's ever gotten a DNA bomb. You know, it's not like it's that big of an occurrence. It's just a cool thing to go for, and if you actually get it, you just feel ecstatic. So why not put it in the game? Next, let's talk about the maps. The maps in Black Ops 3, I would like for these to be 3-lane balanced maps without a lot of verticality, which is exactly what they are. That's exactly what they're being described to be anyway. The people have actually gotten a chance to play the game early. They mentioned that the maps are actually going to be 3-lane styles. There's not going to be anything more than like 2 layers of verticality. There's not going to be anything more than 2 stories or anything like that. So it's just basically going to be your 3-lane style maps, balanced maps. I don't even care, man, if these things are just mirror maps where the one side of the map is the exact same thing on the other side of the maps. I wouldn't care about that. It'd be cool because it's more balanced that way. I would just like to see 3-lane maps that are relatively balanced, that don't have a lot of verticality, and that's apparently what we're getting in the game, which I think is pretty cool. But for me, and I've said this many times on my channel, maps are always, to me, about the color scheme and the location, right? Don't please, Treyarch, which who's, I'm sure, is not even watching this video, it's not even on your radar, nor would it matter, because I'm sure the game's just about done by this point, but I'm just talking about Black Ops 3, just to talk about Black Ops 3, because I know you guys like to hear about it, and I just like discussing stuff like this with you guys in the comments and stuff, so that's why I'm doing it. But please, don't just throw us into, like, generic Future City 1, or generic futuristic Building 2. You know, don't just do that. Make the locations interesting. Make sure they are bright. Make sure they are vibrant. I want them to be visually stimulating, you know? Yesterday, yesterday, right? So yesterday on Dear Nero, the first custom zombie gameplay that we had was actually a map called Warzone. And Warzone is a freaking cool custom zombie map because you start off on a sunny beach. Like, it was really just enjoyable for me to play on the map. I kept wanting to go back and continue playing it because it's like, wow, this map is really fun. Because it's, I actually ended up beating it last night. I wasn't recording or anything. I actually ended up beating it and like getting the Bible ending and stuff. It's like, I want to keep going back to that map after I tried it out for yesterday's Dear Nero. After my first time ever trying, I'm like, I want to continue going back because it was so bright and colorful and vibrant that I wanted to explore it a bit more. Whereas if it were just like a dark and dreary one, maybe I wouldn't be as inclined to want to go back and play it. I think people definitely underestimate that a lot in their games. If you want Call of Duty to be a serious game, it can still be serious and still good looking. You look at a lot of the maps that Black Ops 2 had, which I'm going to assume, and I've also heard apparently that Black Ops 3 has like the same color palette as Black Ops 2. Those maps were colorful, man. You think of Cove, which is a DLC map. You think of Grind, which was also a DLC map. You think of just some of the general maps that they've had. A lot of them were DLC maps that are coming to mind right now that were like super colorful, but there are also some standard maps. Like you think of Raid, everything's basically white and sunny on that map. It's just good looking. You know, Turbine, as much as I didn't like playing on the map, was also very bright and colorful. Like there was no dark and dreary maps on that game, aside from maybe Aftermath, which in my opinion was like the one bad map on that game. But you know, just have a nice, bright, and visually stimulating map system. I would love for that. And also, random time of the day and random weather generators. Why have they not implemented that? You know, they did. They actually were hiring this, right? They were hiring over at Sledgehammer somebody to put together a weather system in their game. And I thought it was actually from my videos. And if you guys haven't seen them, I guess I'll put links to them down in the video description. So basically, the idea is make it so. And I'm trying to do this in fast forward so we don't take forever with this video. But basically, what it is every time you load up a map, I want there to be a 25% chance that map is going to be daytime, a 25% chance it's going to be morning time, a 25% chance it's going to be sunset, a 25% chance it's going to be nighttime, right? And then also, I want random weather. So there's your random time generator. I'd also want a 25% chance that it's going to be snowy, 25% chance it's going to be sunny, 25% chance it's going to be cloudy, 25% chance it's going to be raining. And of course, you could change that based upon where the location of the map is. So the example I gave in the video, which once again, there's links to this down in the video description if you want to open up in a new tab and check it out after this video is over. The example I gave was like the map Grind in Black Ops 2. Very bright and colorful map, awesome looking. It's set in Venice, California. So maybe make it so there's like 36% chance of sunny, of cloudy, and of rainy, but then have that little tiny like 5% chance down there where it's actually going to be snowy. So it's a very rare occurrence, but it's actually possible for you to look up on that map and have it actually be snowing out on there, and it would just be like such a rare cool occurrence that if it actually happened to you, it would be a whole lot of fun. Of course, it wouldn't change how the map is played or how it's laid out or anything. It would just change the lighting of the map and the weather of the map. That's all it would change. It wouldn't change around anything like that. It would just change around how the map looks, and every single time you play, you would have a ton of fun just with all the variety that's involved. Actually, I did math with this, and if you just take like your typical Call of Duty game and just kind of estimate, because of course it's different for each game, but if you just estimate that there's roughly 15 multiplayer maps on the game when you actually load it in, like the day one, you buy the game, you load onto your console or your PC or whatever, the multiplayer maps that are there by default, like your stock maps, let's say there's 15 of them, and if there's 4 time of the day generators and there's 4 weather generators, meaning there's going to be 240 total map possibilities on day one. It would be so cool if they were to implement something like that, man. So cool. I've been talking about it for several years now. They totally need to go ahead and do that. Next up, let's talk about the game modes. Bring them all, man. Bring all the game modes into this game. Have all your core standard stuff, all your tried and trues that everybody loves, your team death matches, your kill confirms, your dominations and search and destroys, but also throw in a lot of the new stuff, search and rescue, throw in sabotage. Bring that game mode back, man. That thing has been in Call of Duty since Black Ops 1? I want to say, was it in Modern Warfare 3? I don't remember. It's been a long time, though. It's been a long time since Sabotage was actually featured in Call of Duty game 4. Bring that back! Demolition, man! I don't care. Demolition's fun. Sure, it's a spawn trappy game, but you know what you're getting into if you go into Demolition. Bring back War or Momentum, whichever one you want to call it. I'd prefer War because it sounds cooler, but bring back that game mode. Bring back Blitz. Blitz was pretty cool. Reinforced Call of Duty Ghost actually had some pretty cool game modes in it. So, yeah, bring back that stuff. Bring it all in there. I understand it would cost more, but who cares? From a consumer standpoint, we want it all, right? right, from their standpoint, throughout to try and make as much money as possible with their game and not have a ton of maintenance by maintaining all these servers. But for us, from my like my wish list, my heart of hearts, I want all the game modes that's like ever been featured in Call of Duty before to actually be in there. The same thing with hardcore. I want people that like to play hardcore to have a ton of variety with the game modes that they're playing. And the more options, the better. Honestly, the more options, the better. Of course, I would want them to bring back party game modes like gun game. I want them to bring back things like one in the chamber. But be sure to add variety to those game modes, like add different gun rotations to gun game and sharpshooter and things like that. And there should definitely, in my opinion anyway, be a 9v9 domination only game mode. That might just be me, but I did see some people agreeing with this on the last video, man. I would love a 9v9 domination game mode, because I play a lot of Ground War. It's primarily the game mode I play. And when I'm playing it, I'm really doing it for domination. I want that 9-on-9 domination. It's a whole lot of fun. And I sit there and I suffer through team death matches and kill confirms, just waiting for the next domination match. And if there was just a 9-on-9 dom playlist, I would like that a lot more. And also, just to kind of round things off, why not add a third-person game mode or a playlist just for fun? They had it in Modern Warfare 2, why not just throw it in this game for fun? Because if there's going to be customization for your characters anyway, why not add a third-person game mode where you can actually see your character in all of his fancy outfits? That would be kind of cool. Next up, let's talk about zombies. Now we've covered most of the things actually in the multiplayer. Let's go back. I'm scrolling up here. We covered the prestige system and the leveling speed and the weapons and the perks and the killstreaks and the maps and the game modes. I think that's just about all for the actual multiplayer itself. I'm sure I'm going to forget something, but let's go on to zombies here. So I've actually discussed this in this week's episode of Dear Near, which was actually posted up yesterday. Basically, to kind of summarize it, in zombies, I want more of the same. I've loved all the maps that Treyarch has released for zombies. I loved all the ones in World at War. I loved all the ones in Black Ops. I loved all the ones in Black Ops 2. In my opinion, they've all just been fantastic. They were all pretty good. Lots of variety in there, and I like that. I just ask that zombies actually have a more traditional system than what we've had before, right? I definitely want a more traditional system. I don't want thruster packs and wall running, which are going to be features in the multiplayer. I don't want them to really be too much of a part of Black Ops 3 zombies. You know, I don't want it to be like exo zombies. I want it to be zombies. You know, that may just be me there. But I also would like to see a progression system. They are going to have a progression system. I'm definitely happy about that. They said there's going to be a leveling system where, of course, you can barely ever play zombies and still be able to get on high rounds on the map, stuff like that. But for people that like to play zombies a ton, there's going to be unlock systems. Systems and progression systems and things for you to do, which definitely sounds like a lot of fun. Looks like they're going to be expanding upon the system they had in Black Ops 2. If you remember, there was like the skull, then there was the skull with a knife through it, and there was the skull with the shotguns, and then there was just the crossbones, like the X crossbones there as well. So there was a rank system in there, but apparently they're going to be expanding upon that in Black Ops 3, which sounds like a ton of fun, man. That definitely sounds like a whole lot of fun. I'd also like they're just throwing in there, just have a zombies combat record. That'd be cool, man. I would like a zombies combat record just for more stats, just for more fun. You know, I'd like to know how many kills I've gotten with the starting pistol. How many kills have I gotten with the ray gun? How many kills have I gotten with the AK-47 upgraded or stuff like that? You know, I just think it'd be neat to have that kind of information available to you, and maybe they could do that. They had a system like that in Black Ops 2, but everybody's favorite weapon always just said M1911. So I'm wondering, is like, well, what does that mean? Like, is it based on like how much time you have with that gun? Because of course everyone's number one's gonna be M1911. It's the gun you start out with on every single map, you know. So it was weird. I don't know, but they should definitely add a combat record in there. And speaking of combat records, I would love for the combat record in the multiplayer to be nearly a copy and paste, just a carbon copy of the Black Ops 1 combat record. We talked about this in yesterday's Dear Nero, man. I loved all the random details that you could find out in that combat record. I love knowing exactly how many times I've called in an RCXD. I love knowing exactly how many kills I've gotten with it. I love knowing exactly how many times I have thrown a sticky grenade in that game. You know, I love it knowing exactly how many frag grenades I've thrown. I love knowing how many times I've died to a sniper rifle or stuff like that. I love knowing my kill death ratio while holding this specific rocket launcher. You know, I love knowing all of that stuff. It's just all the cool information you would get from that is awesome. Of course, Advanced Warfare and Black Ops do have combat records, but they're not nearly as detailed and pulls as much numbers as what they had in Black Ops 1. So try to bring that back, man. I would love that. Let's talk about campaign a little bit. Campaign, I don't really have, honestly, too many thoughts on the Black Ops 3 campaign. We've learned a little bit of what it's going to be about. Like, kind of like the setting itself, without trying to spoil too much, is going to be pretty much just a dark and dreary future. We're running out of a lot of our world resources, and we're basically gotten to the point where, like, range combat, where, like, missiles or bombs and stuff like that don't really do a whole lot anymore. So this new kind of Black Ops soldier, where we're all, like, kind of, like, cybernetically enhanced and stuff, those are, like, the big players in wars and stuff. That's basically the setting that we're in, at least the way I understand it. So I'm interested to see about that, but if I could toss in, like, a suggestion, I think it'd be cool to have some throwback missions to kind of show us how we got exactly to this point, because it's going to be a big jump from Black Ops 2 to what we're going to be seeing in Black Ops 3. So give us some throwback missions and maybe allow us to see things that we didn't already see in some of the other campaigns. Like allow us to see stuff from World at War or Black Ops or Black Ops 2. See stuff from those campaigns that maybe we didn't get to see originally playing through those campaigns, just to kind of give us a little bit of a throwback. I think that would be kind of cool. Theater mode. I have a bunch of actual random things here that I just want to point out and just talk about in this video. Theater mode is one of them. It's actually returning, and my only hope is that maybe it's a little bit improved from Black Ops 2. And theater's great, man. I always love the idea of theater in Call of Duty because it allows users to make some really cool cinematic stuff, but there's always been some problems with it. Like, I remember recording zombie footage, or if you wanted to, like, do zombie cinematics in Black Ops 2, it was actually difficult because all of the zombies would be, like, a glowing red. Like, their entire bodies would just be glowing red unless you were, like, selected onto a zombie and following it from its perspective, either in first or third person. It was really weird. So just a little general fixes and polishes here and there, and I'm excited for theater mode to come back, man. Some of the stuff you see, like Banos, it's really cool stuff with theater mode, with like the world's greatest noob tube and all the editing that went into that. You can use some really cool stuff with that, so I'm definitely happy to see theater mode returning. Gunsmith is going to be in the game, and the paint shop is going to be in the game. So Gunsmith, if you guys don't know, is going to basically allow you to create your own quote-unquote variants by adding specific attachments and camos and stuff like that to your gun, as well as you're going to be able to have the paint shop, which is going to allow you to basically make your own camo for, it's kind of like Emblem Editor, but also with weapon camos, where there's going to be layers on the side, the top, and the right. Left, top, and right, I guess I should say. But yeah, you're going to be able to kind of make your own camo. It's going to have to work with the existing camos that are already within the game. So that sounds fun, man. I think it'd be cool. People have been asking to be able to at least have some form of customization to our making our own camos for ages. And it seems like they're going to be having that with this paint shop. So that's going to be pretty cool. Weekly updates. I talked about this in my last video, talking about my wish list for Black Ops 3. I would love for weekly updates to happen to the game. I want them constantly paying attention to bugs, glitches, and weapon balancing. You know, it really stinks when there's like an under the map glitch. We saw this in Ghost, we saw this in Advanced Warfare, where there's an under the map glitch that doesn't get patched for a couple weeks, and every time you load into that map, it's like, oh boy, well, who's going to be exploiting it? You have to play the map completely differently because, you know, you're trying to stop people from getting underneath the map, so you're protecting that particular area rather than paying attention to objectives, or it's frustrating. If there's weekly updates, that won't happen. If a specific gun becomes overpowered because of one update, well, a week later, it could get buffed down, or nerfed down again, I should say. That'd be cool, man. I would just love weekly updates. Of course, it would cost a lot more, and it'd be pretty difficult for the 360 and PS3 versions to actually keep up with this, because, you know, of course, they're having trouble with that here already in Advanced Warfare, but even then again, we don't even know if Black Ops 3 is coming out for those consoles, so I guess we'll have to see, but I think weekly updates would probably be the best thing for everybody in general. Private matches, more options than ever, man. Allow us to build some really cool custom game modes in private matches. That'd be great. One of the things they did in Call of Duty Ghosts, which I wish they would have done, man, but they never did. Give us the option to actually just have Michael Myers in private matches. That way, if we play Michael Myers, which is universally known, I guarantee every COD developer has at least heard of this game. People like to play Michael Myers in private matches with their friends. I had people do it in open lobbies like myself. It's fun to do, man. And if Michael Myers himself were actually there, like he was in Call of Duty Ghosts with the DLC map Fog, that would be pretty cool. You look at Advanced Warfare, allow us to have the Exo Grapple system in private matches just to play around with. You know, that would be pretty cool. Speaking of customizing private stuff, how about a Forge world? Oh my god, man. That would be like the coolest thing in Call of Duty history, but I doubt it'll ever actually be featured. But if you remember Forge world, which was in Halo Reach, I know it was in Halo 4 as well, but it wasn't as good as Halo Reach in my opinion. Yeah, man, that is so much fun. Basically giving you access to like all of the assets of the game itself and being able to build stuff in like a private setting and in this own little world, if you will. Basically, it's like a sandbox mode, but in Halo. I would love to see that in Call of Duty, where we can build our own maps or build our own zombie maps. Actually, right now, at the time of me recording this, I think I have a screenshot from Twitter I guess I could put in here. It's not going to show you anything besides a floor, but I'll have you know I have a floor and four walls so far. I'm very slow. I'm trying to learn this, but I'm working on building my own custom zombie map. I don't know if I'll ever actually do anything with it or if I'll actually get it completed, but I'm actually playing around with it just to see, because I've always been interested in that kind of thing. So I've been working on trying to build like a custom little map there, and it's very hard. It's very confusing. I have to learn whole new programs and stuff, whereas if there was just something simple already built into the game, like a Forge world, it would be so much better for everybody involved. That would just be great. FOV slider, it'll never make it to console, man, but FOV sliders would be fantastic. Like, I play a lot of PC now, and not Call of Duty stuff, but like Borderlands and custom zombies and stuff, which I guess is Call of Duty, but when I play PC, I like to change around my field of view. It's so nice changing around your field of view, but I don't think they're ever going to actually have that on console, because changing your FOV actually causes a bit of instability, I guess, with the game, and that could actually possibly make it so it tanks below 60 FPS in certain situations, because You know, of course, it's running on the hardware that your console has, and you can't really improve it in any way. So, and also, it gives you a slight competitive advantage. But at the same time, there's just a lot of people that actually get sick from, like, the field of view. Like, if you look at a field of view that's, like, a 70 or a 60, you know, you see it, stuff like that. So people actually get sick looking at that. It's just, it's weird. It's too smushed up. It's just a weird field of view. And then some gun models in some games are just so big, it's like, wow, I'd love to just be able to change my field of view so I could see a little bit more. I would love to have that on console, but I don't think it'll ever actually happen, at least in the next few years, but I would love to have that. And the final thing we're going to be talking about is dedicated servers. Some people have brought this up, the idea of having a dedicated server system in Black Ops 3. I would say maybe make it similar to Battlefield in that you can actually make your own server by paying money for it, of course, and you can make your own server, and from there you can change around the rules, and you can change around the map rotation and the game modes and all that stuff. I think that would be pretty fun. I would make like a Nero Cinema server. It would be like only the game modes I like on only maps I like, and you guys could join and play anytime you want, and that would be the only server I play in, so I'd be able to play with subscribers a lot, which would be a ton of fun. But I doubt they'll have it. I doubt they would have a dedicated server system, but I wouldn't be against them having it, nor would I be against them not having it. You know, I'm okay with Call of Duty the way it's always been, but I would also be okay with Call of Duty if it had a dedicated server system similar to what they've had in the Battlefield series. And ladies and gentlemen, I believe that is just about everything, and I'm gonna start cringing because I'm gonna forget. There's gonna be something that I'm gonna forget here, but I don't know what that would be, and it's bothering me. So we got leveling speed and the leveling system, the prestige system, we got weapons, we've got perks, we've got kill streaks, we went over maps and game modes and zombies and combat records, the campaign, went over theater mode returning, gunsmith, paint shop, weekly updates, private matches, forge world somehow, FOV sliders somehow, as well as dedicated servers. Is there really anything out there? I talked about the recoil when we talked about the guns. I want there to be a lot more recoil. I talked about the style of map. I want to talk about the weather generator. I talked about the time generator. I know I'm going to be forgetting something. I talked about the game modes. I talked about zombies. Really just more of the same with zombies. I talked about Forge World. I don't know, man. I may be forgetting something, but in the comments, if you guys feel as though I forgot something, feel free to let me know, like, hey, Nero, what would be your opinion on this? I would be more than happy to give you guys my opinion on anything. You guys know me. I'm an open book. I'll let you guys know just where I'm at when it comes to talking about Call of Duty, talk about games, my own thoughts, my opinions, stuff like that. So leave your guys' opinions. Leave your guys' comments in the comment section below. I'd be more than interested to actually read through those and reply to a lot of them, because I like talking about this kind of stuff with you guys. You guys have some cool ideas. That's the fun part of these videos, is just talking about stuff. And now let's go ahead and look at this. It's looking like this is going to be about a 30-minute video. So this is about... not longer than Dear Nero, but regardless, hope you guys all enjoy it. And if you did, please be sure to leave a rating where you guys feel it deserves. Once again, let me know in the comment section below, what are your guys' thoughts and opinions on Black Ops 3? What would you like to see? What would you not like to see? Let us know about that. Let's have a nice discussion. I hope you guys all enjoyed this video. And if you did, please be sure to leave a rating. Hope you guys all have a wonderful day.